Hello my dear children, welcome back once again to your mathematics class. Children, last session we people have seen a different types of numbers, its definition with examples. Today let us solve based on that our exercise problem. So let us start. Let us solve some exercise 8C problems based on these different types of numbers. Okay, so first question. Write down all the prime numbers between 10 and 20. So, between 10 and 20 means don't include this 10 and 20. Between that, which are the prime numbers are coming, that we have to see and write. So, 11 is a prime number. Yes or no? Because having only two factors. Then 12, no. 13 is a prime number. Then 14, 15, 16. No, 17 is a prime number and 19. So, these are the prime number between 10 and 20. Where if you see, all these prime number having only two factor. One and that number itself. Okay, children. Now, second one. Write down all the composite number less than 20. Means from 1 to 19. Less than 20, they told. No, from 1 to 19. We have to see which are the composite numbers coming in there. So, if you see, 2 is not a composite number, 3 is not a composite number, 4 is a composite number, then 6, then 8, then 9, then 10, then 12, then 14, then 15. Then 16, then 18. These are the composite numbers, children. Less than 20. That's why we have taken till less than 20. If you see here, 4 having 3 factor, 6 having more than 2, 8 also having more than 2 factor, 9 is also having more than 2 factor, 10, 12, 14, 15, 16, 18, such a number which having the more than 2 factor, those numbers are the composite number. So, sometimes they may ask less than 20. According to the question, you people have to write the answer. Sometimes they may ask, find the composite number between some given number. Then we have to find out the between those given number. Now, here it is less than 20, so we have find out till less than 20. According to the question, you have to find the answer. But for that, you should know thoroughly with what is meant by prime number, composite number, even number and odd number. Okay. So, the next question, encircle the prime numbers. So, they have given some numbers here. From that, we have to observe, find and find out the prime numbers. So, 14 is a prime number? No. 19 is a prime number? Yes. Because having only two factor, one and number itself. So, encircle means you have to circle that number. 37? Yes, it is a prime number. Then, 61? Prime number. 45 is not a prime number. It is coming in other tables. Then, 69 is also coming. 77 is also coming. It is not a prime number. 81 is also not a prime. And 99 is also not a prime. So, only 3 prime numbers are there in this. 19, 37 and 61. Let us see the next example. Encircle the composite numbers now. Again, they have given some group of number. We have to observe and we have to find out which are the composite number. For that, we have to circle, children. Now, 21 is a composite number. Yes. 21 is coming in other tables also. Then, 31, no. 39, so 39 is a composite number. 49 is composite number. 51 is composite number. 53 is not composite number. Then, 63 is composite number. Then, 91 is also a composite number. So, these are the composite number, children, which having the more than two factors. Okay. Next example, children. Write the number which is prime as well as even number. We have to write such a number. That number should be prime as well as even number. See that number, children? 2. is a number which is prime as well as even number. Now next one, write the smallest prime number. The smallest prime number is 2 only. The smallest prime number is 2. Correct. And circle the even numbers. From the given group of number, we have to identify the even number and we have to circle it. For that, you should know what is meant by even number. So, 13 is even number, children? No. 21 is? No. 58? Yes. It is even number. 76? Yes. It is even number. 91? No. 104? Even number. 116? Even number. 309? No. So, where? If you observe, if the number is big also, you have to observe the ones place. In the ones place, 8, 6, 4, 6 and all numbers are there. So, these are the even number. Okay, my dear children. See now, next example. And circle the odd number. Again, some group of numbers they have given. From that, we have to observe and we have to circle the odd number. So, now, 25 is odd number. 34, it is even number. 53, odd number. 69, odd number. 96, even number. 103, odd number. 115, odd number. 203, odd number. So children, 25, 53, 69, 103, 115, 203, these are the odd numbers. If the numbers are big, please observe the ones place of that number. Automatically you will understand which are the odd and even number. Okay, children. Now, next one. Write the smallest number which when added to an even number makes the odd number. So, smallest even number is what, children? 2. For that, if we add the number 1, what we will get? You will get the odd number. So, which number we can add? The smallest number? 1. So, the answer is what, children? 1. Okay. So, if we add the 1 to the even number, we will get odd number. Okay. Now, next one. Is 1 a prime number? No. It is not a prime number. 1 is not a prime number. Because for 1, there are no 2 factors and prime number says that a number should have 2 factors. 1 is not having 2 factors, so therefore it is not a prime number. And also it is not a composite number because 1 don't have more than 2 factors also. So 1 is neither prime nor composite. So the answer is no. Understood, children? Write all the even numbers between 35 and 55. Means again, here between 35 and 55, children, we have to find it. We have to find out the even numbers. So, after 35, 36 is an even number, yes. Then 37, no. 38 is even number. Then 40, then 42, then 44, then 46, then 48. Then 50, then 52, then 54, up to 55. Between it is. We cannot write that also. So, these are the numbers between 35 and 55 and these are even numbers. Understood? Now, the next question. Write all the odd numbers between 40 and 70. Means between 40 and 70, we have to find out now odd number. So, after 40. 41 is an odd number. Then 43, then 45, 47, 49, 51, 53, then 55, then 57, then 59, then 61, then 63, then 65, then 67, then 69. So, these all are the odd numbers between 40 and 70. So, however they ask the question between and all, you have to understand and you have to write the answer. Only here it is required that you should know what is meant by prime number, even number, odd number and composite number, children. Okay, so children, I hope today's all the different types of numbers you people have understood. Go through all the problems, solve the exercise, practice it. And today we'll wind up our session here. Next time with new subtopic. Till then, bye-bye. Stay safe. Take care, children.